Hello and welcome to the episode 19 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, the show will be short and sweet, featuring multiple live performances, a radio broadcast, negotiation for a tour, and a nice recording session. On the 19th of January 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, were at the Alexandra Hall in Liverpool for another BK Promotions evening. In 1962, still with Pete Best on drums, the lads had a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. Then, at night, they performed a gig at the Tower Ballroom in Wallasey. On the 19th of January 1963, the Beatles were at the Town Hall Ballroom in Dodington. As it had happened on the 18th of January for the Floral Hall Ballroom in Morecambe, roadie Neil Aspinall was substituted by Les Hurst, roadie of Jerry and the Pacemakers, since he was still in bed with flu. In 1964, the Beatles performed yet another couple of sets at the Olympia Theatre in Paris, France, one in the afternoon and one in the evening. Part of the matinee performance was broadcast live by French radio station Europe 1 for their program Musicorama between 1 and 2 p.m. The listeners enjoyed performances by Trini Lopez, Sylvie Vartan, and five songs by the Fab Four. From Me to You, This Boy, I Want to Hold Your Hand, She Loves You, and Twist and Shout. On this date, in 1965, Brian Epstein flew to the United States to negotiate and fix the dates for the Beatles' next North American tour. It was decided that, to accommodate the high demand for tickets, the band would play in stadiums, arriving in armored cars. These vehicles would wait with the engine on next to the stage during the performance and would drive the band back to their hotels as soon as the show ended. All in all, it was a claustrophobic and quasi-military operation, attempting to mix show business and safety. The big question was, would all this fuff work? We will find out together in a later episode. Right now, instead, we can move to the 19th of January 1967, with the Beatles at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road. The day saw the start of the band's work on A Day in the Life. Between 7:30 p.m. and 2:30 a.m., four takes of the rhythm tracks were completed, but the song was not totally worked out yet. For a start, its name for the session was In the Life Of. The song would have acquired its final name by the next recording session. Moreover, the 24 bars leading to the middle section were still empty. Still undecided on what to put in that space, the band had Mal Evans count out the bars, backed by a piano playing the same chord over and over, with an alarm clock going off at the end of the bridge section. It would later turn out to be another fortunate experiment, since the ring of the alarm fit Paul's lyrics for the middle section vignette. Woke up, fell out of bed, and so on. The initial rehearsals for the song, recorded and then erased, saw John Lennon at the piano, Paul McCartney on organ, George Harrison on acoustic guitar, and Ringo Starr on congas. The four proper takes, instead, saw John on guitar, Paul on piano, George on maracas, and Ringo on congas. Jeff Emerick is quoted in the complete Beatles recording sessions, commenting on the generous amount of echo on John Lennon's vocals during the recording of the song. The levels of the effect were turned up high enough for the echo to just start feeding on itself. According to Emerick, John sang with the effect in his headphones, learning to phrase his singing around the echo, using it as a rhythmic device to perfect his part. With this, we can conclude this episode of What a Fab Day. Please remember to check www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to support this podcast and my other music-related projects. In addition, in the description, you can find the usual link to the Amazon affiliate list to all sorts of material that I have used to write the podcast. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.